And I first heard about Bitcoin from this article, which came out in InfoWorld on May 24th, 2010, which was an article about seven interesting open source projects. I don't remember how I stumbled across the article. It was probably one of the many blogs I read linked to it. So about a month later, I had launched the Bitcoin faucet, which you probably all got a few, well, depending on how early you were, either five bitcoins, which is how many bitcoins the faucet was giving away to start, or if you got them last night, then one micro bitcoin, which is how much the faucet is giving out today. So when I heard about that article in May and decided the faucet would be a great first project to kind of get my feet wet in playing with bitcoins, I just kind of got sucked in and got more and more involved in the project, got involved in the Bitcoin forums and the community, started to submit patches to Satoshi, who would then rip them apart and send them back to me and say, no, you did it wrong, and then re-implement it. All the way through kind of December 2010, when Satoshi started to step backwards. And he did it in an interesting way. He actually sent me an email and asked me if it'd be okay if he could put my email address as one of the people to contact on the Bitcoin.org homepage. I said, sure, yeah, no problem. You can put my Bitcoin address there. And so he did that, and then at the same time, he took his email address away, which I didn't expect to happen, but I think it was kind of his way of saying, kind of pushing me forward. And the last email I've got from Satoshi was in April of 2011. So that kind of gives you a history of the project so far. So why me? Why am I the lead developer of Bitcoin? Well, Jeff pushed me. He kind of encouraged me. I think because I have a pretty thick skin, so you can call me an idiot, and yeah, whatever. Because I know I'm not perfect, so I tend not to rush into things rashly because I screw up quite regularly. But I think my virtue is that I will listen to you if you tell me I'm screwing up. And also because nobody else, frankly, stepped forward and decided to say, yeah, I'll be the guy who tries to herd the cats. I should stress it's not because of any prior experience in either open source software or the financial world. My background is in kind of a serial entrepreneur doing a bunch of different startups. Although I did have a prior experience that actually reminds me a lot of Bitcoin, and that's I was kind of the chief architect of the virtual reality modeling language standard, which never actually kind of went anywhere, but just dealing with a very diverse community and trying to get people to agree on kind of what the direction to go in, my VRML experience reminds me a lot of Bitcoin. So I guess I do have some semi-relevant prior experience.